Yesterday, all the Beatles seemed so far away, except for Paul McCartney. He was seen photographed and walking the streets of Metuchen by one John Manzo, who joins us now. John, how you doing?
Hey, man, how you doing, Steve?
Dude, you got to be. Are you still lit? Are you still thinking about it, replaying it in your mind over and over and over again?
A little bit. It's a little bit of a whirlwind. It's kind of funny.
So now, the first thing I'm thinking of is this has got to be the greatest, you know, your greatest dream and your worst nightmare together, because you're a big Beatle fan, right? You played in a Beatles band.
Oh, yeah. Okay. We definitely played some Beatles songs.
Okay. Now, and here you see Paul McCartney, and that's the dream. And the nightmare is he's talking to you, and you want to keep this going. But behind you, because it's Jersey, you got people driving. You're in your car. People are driving behind you going, come on, move. We got to go someplace.
Yeah, pretty much. It happened really, really quick. I mean, I stopped. Right. I saw him, actually. He was running around taking pictures.
Really?
And he looked familiar, and then he was crossing the street in front of me.
Right.
And I'm actually on the phone with a buddy of mine, and I'm like, yo, Paul McCartney's right in front of me. And then he walked across the street, and he started to turn. I rolled my window down, and, I said it a little differently, but for radio, I said, what the hell are you doing in Metuchen?
You didn't drop an F-bomb on Paul, did you?
I definitely dropped an F-bomb.
You dropped an F-bomb on Paul?
Yeah, and he cracked up. It was funny. Come on, that's a good Jersey welcome, no?
You know what? That is the perfect Jersey welcome, because you may not know this, but for real, we curse more than any other state in the Union.
I could believe that.
It's the truth. So, I mean, by you dropping an F-bomb on Paul, that's like saying, come on, bring it in. Bring it in, big fella. That's absolutely right. And he got it. That is so cool. Now, how long did it take you to, first off, say, gee, it looks like Paul McCartney. It can't be. It must be. It is? I mean, were you convinced when you said, what the F are you doing here, that it was Paul McCartney?
Oh, yeah. As soon as he walked in front of my Jeep, I knew it was him.
Now,
without a doubt.
When he's doing the walk, is he walking across the street? Is he doing the Abbey Road walk? Is he barefoot?
Let me tell you something. I tried to get my phone out so fast, because it would have been epic if I was able to get the picture of him crossing the crosswalk. It would have been great, but unfortunately, I wasn't able to.
When you ask him, you weren't going to curse at him. You weren't going to drop F bombs. Couldn't you ask him to do the walk again?
He was. Let me tell you, he was like a ghost. He was in and out. We talked for a few brief seconds.
Right.
He let me take the picture, and then he was out. There was people on the street. They didn't even see him.
Wow. Wow. So you know what? He usually doesn't take pictures, too. He's said this many times. I will talk to you, but I really don't want to do the picture thing.
I heard that. But he did. He was, you know, he was real cool about it. He told me he was there because his wife lived in the area.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's why he was there. He was kind of taking pictures of the buildings real quick. And then we talked for a couple seconds. And then he was out and I went back to work.
So what did you talk about? Did you give any deep, dark secrets?
No, nothing like that. Like I said, just that his wife lived in the area. That was it. Pretty short-lived.
He didn't say, like, I never liked John or anything like that? No?
Yeah, no. I tried to get him to go to, I wanted to get him to go to the bar across the street, and then we could sit down and have a pint and, you know, enjoy it.
Of course.
And not? Really shoot it.
Well, wait a minute, dude. You are the proprietor of Be My Guest Personal Chef and Catering. Why don't you tell him that you've got so many vegan dishes you want him to taste?
Yeah, like I wish I did. Just no time for that. I would have rather talked about a lot of other things than that.
All right, so let me ask you this now. If you could, now that you've gained your composure and you've probably gone through this a billion times, why didn't I ask him this? Why didn't I ask him that? Why didn't I ask him this? What would you, given the moment again, and you get to ask Paul one question, what would you ask him?
Just what was it like? Just everything. I mean, he's the most iconic person around. I mean, one of the best bands in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And just to say, what was it like? And just listen to him.
Yeah, that was the best thing. And you know what? Just to hear him talk to you. And you told him that he was awesome.
Yeah. He let me take the picture. So I said, you're awesome. He said, no, you're awesome. I took the picture and he was gone.
Just like that. But you see, John, that's a Jersey guy, right? First you drop an F-bomb on him, and then you tell him he's awesome. You can't get this anywhere else.
That's right, only in Jersey.
Oh, my God. All right, man. So, listen, I want to thank you so much for coming on. And
thank you.
I hope to God. You know, first of all, plug your place. You know, tell me about Be My Guest Personal Chef and Catering.
Be My Guest Personal Chef and Catering, right in downtown Metuchen. So I do personal chef experiences. I do a healthy meal prep delivery service. I do cooking classes. Anything that has to do with food, I'm your guy.
BeMyGuestCatering.com.
Yep.
All right. Best of luck. Keep in touch. And I hope, let's see, Ringo, I hear Ringo may be coming to Asbury Park in June, so you may want to start hanging out down there.
Oh, nice.
You got it, pal. Take it easy.
All right, Steve. Thanks, man.
You got it. John Manzo. How about that?